Phil, Nova Scotia. You are looking live inside the Horton High School gymnasium. It's day one and game two of the 2024 School Sport Nova Scotia Division One Boys Basketball Championships. It's the eight-seeded and wild card from the Western Region, Yarmouth Consolidated Memorial High School Vikings, taking on the number one-seeded and Capital Region champion, the Millwood High School Knights, who finished third last year and played in the provincial title game in 2004-05 season. And they are looking to get back there this year as the number one seed. Good afternoon, everyone. Vince Williams on hand. It's a David versus Goliath affair, but it's not an impossible game to win. Thus the cliches. That's why they play the game. As the Vikings will take on the Knights for the second time this season. The first matchup, the Knights knocked off the Vikings by 13. But this is for pretty much all the Marlboros to survive and move on. Number one versus number eight. And let's introduce you to the starting lineups as we'll send it over to the public address announcer for the starting lineups of both teams. Tip off on the other side here on Maritime Athletic Profiles. So it's the Knights and the Vikings, one versus eight. For the Knights, the Capital Region champions is Tersemi, Otho, Colley, Reed, and Lucas will get the start for Damon Cole. And for the Yarmouth Consolidated Memorial High School Vikings, the wild card qualifier from the Western Region is Villa, Fowler, Belanger, Middleton, and Habib. Reed and Fowler jump it up. Tap coming right into the broadcast area, and it will be Knights possession as Lucas will trigger the inbound side out. Tshemi picked up by Middleton. Quick ball movement. Lucas corner three. Got it right off the back. First field goal from downtown. Great ball movement by the Knights, and Lucas knocks down the triple. Knights on the run out. Reed saves it on the end line. Tshemi knocks down the jumper. Quick 5-0 start here for Millwood. Three-pointer not there. As Habib try to knock down the three. It'll deflect out of bounds. It'll be Millwood basketball. Otho. Paul Otho drives baseline. Jaden Lucas back-to-back triples won't go. Reed with the rebound. Lays it up. Can't get it to fall. Gets his own rebound. In the second attempt not there. Ball batted around. Picked up by the Vikings. Fowler on the run out, and he'll lay it up and in. As Tariq Fowler, the 6'3" senior, will open up the scoring here for the Vikings. Lucas, corner three. That'll rim out. Lucas, 1-for-3 from downtown. Now the Vikings with an opportunity to tie it up or get within one. Habib finds it and lays it up and in. And that's his first field goal. Otho for three, and he's fouled. And Paul Otho will go to the line to shoot three. 6'4" senior. Knocks down the second. And Otho will go 1 for 3. Reed with the rebound. Paul for three, won't fall. Bat around, tipped here by Cauley, and he'll lay it up and in. Fabian Cauley, the 6'6" junior, with his first field goal of the game. Here's Habib, spins in the lane. Wild shot picked up by Cauley. Tashimi, the read. Lucas, great ball movement. Otho can't save it. And that'll be a turnover for the Knights. Habib behind the back. Fowler gets inside, flips it up. Reed with the rebound. Cauley on the run out, almost stolen by Villa. Last touch by Fowler. And it'll be Millwood basketball. Lucas will trigger the inbound. It'll stay with the Knights. Lucas again will inbound on the baseline. Drops it off down low. The read. Can't finish. Gets his own rebound and he'll bank it home. And Donovan Reed, after a couple cracks in tight, able to knock down his first field goal of the game. Villa. Middleton will pull it out. Shot clock winding, under 10. Fowler, nice spin and lays it up and in. Beautiful move there by Tariq Fowler. He's got four. Otho thought about three. Blow by, drops it off, blocked by Fowler. It will stay with the Knights, as Cauley's denied in tight by Fowler. And Fabian will sit down. Tyler Mulvale will come in. The 6'2" sophomore. Lucas leaves it short. Second chance here for the Knights. Otho for three. Won't go. Tashemi with another offensive rebound in this offensive sequence. Here's Lucas from downtown. That's off the side of the backboard, secured by Belanger. Villa inside to Belanger, that's out of his reach. Vikings have never won the Division I championship for boys basketball. Come into this one, the eighth seed in the tournament. The Knights looking for their first as the favorite. Was last in the championship game in 2003-04 season, when they lost to the St. Patrick's High School Fighting Irish. Here's Fowler. Euro step. Can't finish. Knights on the run out. three-pointer. As Miller left it short, saved it on the end line. Mulville for three, got it. Knocks down the triple on the second chance opportunity. The rebound by Ryan Miller. And Tyler knocks down his first field goal of the game. Villa picks up the loose ball, step through, and he'll draw the contact. Reuven Villa, the senior, will go to the line to shoot a pair. Chris Coggins will come in. Habib will sit down for the Vikings. Villa leaves the first one short. He'll go one for two. Fowler gets a hand on it. It will stay with the Knights. Toshemi crosses up. Gets it back. Quickly moves it. I'll throw into the corner. Skip past the shimmy for three. Can't hit. And Reed try to keep it alive. And possession will go over to the Vikings. Yarmouth with six seniors. Along with four sophomores. And four freshmen. 628 enrolled at Yarmouth Consolidated Memorial High School as Fowler hits another. He's got six of the nine for the Vikings. Reed. Quick ball movement. 3-2 matchup zone. Reed, shot clock winding down. He's fouled by Belanger, and Donovan Reed will shoot two. Shane Lucas in there for the first time. 6 foot grade nine for the Millwood Knights. Millwood comes into these championships with seven seniors, five freshmen, and two juniors and two grade nines. One of them, number eight, Shane Lucas. Reed will go one for two. Just over 600 students enrolled at Millwood High School, located in Middle and Lower Sackville, Nova Scotia. Belanger, that rolls out. Fowler with the putback, not there. And Lucas can't handle the outlet pass. That'll be turnover number three committed by the Knights. Victorian Oliver checks in for the first time. The freshman for Millwood. And Fowler again with the putback. He's got 8 points in the quarter. That leads all scores. Miller's corner three won't fall. Fowler with the rebound. Middleton thought about three, drives, flips it up and in. Outstanding decision there by Dante Middleton. That's his first field goal of the game. So Delonte gets on the board. Oliver, skip pass, picked off by Villa. Reuven on the bounce, and he'll miss, and foul will be committed by the Knights. As Molvo will be picked up the personal here. Fowler will check out. Habib will come back for the Vikings. It'll be their possession as they'll trigger the inbound on the baseline. Trailing by one, looking to take the lead on this possession. Delange can't handle the inbounds. Lucas on the run out, foul, plus one. And he'll go to the line for a chance for the three-point play. Outstanding run out there by the grade nine, Shane Lucas. He'll step up to the free throw line for the and one. He'll knock it down. Lead back up to four for the Knights. That's Habib, fouled by Lucas. Backdoor catch by Delante, can't finish. Beautiful inbound play, pass by Middleton, can't finish, and they pay for it down the other end as Mulville knocks down the three-pointer. That's Tyler's second. He's got six in the quarter. And Reed will be called for the push. Jack Wiseman, number 23, and Braxton Phillip, both seniors, will check in for the Vikings. Just under 2 minutes remaining in the quarter. Here's Villa. Reuven gets inside. Oliver back the other way. Quick ball movement into the corner. Lucas, shot clock winding down. Miller for three, that'll rim out. Put back, not there. Second chance coming up. Oliver steps inside. Corner three, that'll rim out. They'll get it right back up. And Reed will be fouled. Five chances on this sequence here for the Knights. And Donovan Reed will go to the line to shoot a pair. So the Vikings having their difficulties on the defensive glass. Reed will miss the first. And Donovan will go one for two. Altho will come in for him. Tariq Fowler will check in, who's got eight in the quarter of the 13 for the Vikings. Minute 14 remaining. Here's Habib. Fowler crosses up Oliver. Shot clock under 10. And Fowler steps out of bounds. He'll turn it over. Under a minute remaining in the quarter. Oliver will bring it over the timeline. Miller chased off the three-point line. Quick ball movement. Under 10. That three won't fall. Here's Fowler. He'll bring it over the timeline. Habib inside, draws the double. Won't go. Phillip loses the handle. Movo's attempt at the rim will be denied. Now Fowler back the other way. Fowler's banker not there. Oliver. Miller. He'll lay it up and in. And that'll do it as Miller's run out. Able to stretch the lead to 10. It's their largest. Millwood lead after one quarter. We're back after these messages with Maritime Athletic Profiles coverage of the 2024 School Sport Nova Scotia Division I Boys Basketball Championships.
Life moves fast. You've just got to be ready for it. For big moves and fresh starts. And for promises to stay in touch when they get there. For making sure nothing gets missed. For getting the whole house to feel like home. For knowing that whatever comes next, we can make it work.
Back in Wolfville, Nova Scotia, after 10 minutes, the number one seeded Millwood High School Knights lead the number eight seeded Yarmouth Consolidated Memorial High School Vikings 23-13. And leading the way in that first quarter for the Knights with six, Tyler Mulville, the 6'2" sophomore. And for the Vikings, Tariq Fowler, the senior, with 8 of the 13 points for Yarmouth. Yarmouth come into this tournament never winning the championship here for Division I boys basketball. The Knights, however, looking for their first. Number one seeded team coming into this tournament. The Capital Region champions are the Millwood High School Knights. Their first Capital Region championship in Division I basketball. As mentioned, their last appearance in the championship game in 2004, where they were handed a defeat to the St. Patrick's High School Fighting Irish, as they were in the midst of three straight in that era. So the Vikings possession to start the quarter. Middleton loses the handle. Lucas on the run out, and he'll lay it up and in. Shane Lucas with 5 points off the bench. And Fowler, count it, plus one. And a chance for a three-point play. So Tariq Fowler, good-looking senior for the Vikings. Can't get the free throw to go. Lead back to 10. Oliver almost picked off by Villa. Mulville for three, way out. Try to beat the shot clock, just scrape the front of the rebound. Excuse me, the rim. Otho will pick up the loose ball. He'll step back for three. Got it. He's up to 4. Belanger gets inside. Throws up a wild shot picked up by Fowler, and he'll lay it up and in. Fowler up to 12 now. And the meter's still running. Shot clock winding down, and Mulville flips it up and in. So after a couple threes in that first quarter, Mulville able to get inside. Fowler's three won't go. Last touch by the Vikings. Jaden Lucas will come in. Lucas got the scoring started in this one, knocking down the first field goal of the game from downtown. Here's Oliver. He'll lose the handle. Closely guarded there by Middleton. Millwood get it over the timeline. Miller for three. Won't go. Habib with the rebound. And he'll get it ripped away by Lucas. Lucas drops it off to his brother, Jaden, and he'll bank it in. Special delivery for Shane Lucas to Jaden Lucas. Phillip inside, lays it up and in. So Braxton Phillip, his first points of the game. Fowler steals it. Tariq on the run out. Hesitation, pull up. Fadeaway won't fall. Lucas with the stretch pass up to his brother Jaden, and Jaden can't finish. Oliver with the rebound. Back out to Victorian Oliver. Middleton steals it. Here's Villa. One on two. Forces his way in. Won't go. Shane Lucas now on the attack. That won't fall. Jaden's blocked by Fowler. Step back. And Villa will pull it out. He'll wait for Middleton, and Middleton will be called for the offensive foul. So Delonte Middleton. With the personal. 6:38 remaining in the quarter. They'll call timeout. Is Millwood leading it 32-19. The Knights' first timeout. As Tyler Mulville will lead the way with 8 points for Millwood. Jaden Lucas has 5. And his brother Shane Lucas has 5 as well. For Yarmouth, they're led by Tariq Fowler. He's got 12 in the game. Belanger with 2, Middleton with 2. And Braxton Phillip with 2 as well. So just a reminder that the third game of day number 1 will tip off after the opening ceremonies at 6 p.m. here on Maritime Athletic Profiles. Hombre Academy Ospreys, the 6th-seeded team, will take on the 3rd-seeded team, Cobequid Education Center Cougars. And that'll be an approximately 6 p.m. tip-off here on Maritime Athletic Profiles. So it'll be Millwood basketball out of the timeout. Cauley will come back for Millwood. Jake Darling, number 14, the 6'1" freshman, will check in for the first time for the Knights, along with Aaron Forrest, the 5'10" freshman. Middleton knocks it away from Trashimi. Habib all the way to the rim and will lay it up and in. Great decision there by Gabe, the 6'3" sophomore. Darling's three won't go. Cauley's follow not there. Habib almost throws it away. Strong hands there by Phillip, and he'll tie up Darling. And possession arrow will favor Millwood. to Shimmy. Darling's corner three, won't go. Cauley finds it and he'll lay it up and in. Cauley's got four. Villa on the drive, banks it in. Outstanding explosive move to the rim by Reuben Villa. The 5'9 senior. Lucas gets inside, kick out. Toshimi freezes his man. He'll skip pass over to Darling. Force for three. That'll rim out. Villa with the rebound. Reuben on the run out. Fowler for three-pointer. He'll leave it short, and Toshimi with the rebound. Here's Forrest. Lucas, three-pointer. Wild shot, throws up the air ball. Now Fowler gets it poked away by Lucas, but he's fouled. And Jaden will pick up a personal. Timeout called by Damon Cole. He'll want to talk it over here. Leading by 11 with 4:25 remaining here in the second period. So Millwood's possession out of the timeout. Actually, it's Yarmouth's possession. Middleton, Villa, Belanger, Phillip, and Fowler. For Millwood, it's Lucas. Jaden Lucas, that is. Forrest, Darling, and the aforementioned Lucas with the steal. Collie's out there along with Toshimi. Toshimi gets inside. Kick out. Forrest loses the handle. Lucas blocked by Phillip. Gets it back. Battered around. Tipping not there for Collie. Here's Fowler. Tacks Darling off the bounce. Right hand, lays it up and in. And Fowler's up to 14. Good ball movement by the Knights. And Cauley lays it up and in. Belanger with the tough catch in traffic. Can't corral it. You know, we turned over to Millwood. 3:15 remaining in the quarter and the half. 11-point lead for Millwood. Toshimi drops it off to Jaden. Special delivery as Lucas lays it up and in. Off the outstanding dribble drive and handoff by Toshimi. Middleton chased off the three-point line. Step back, Fowler for three, throws up the air ball. Knocked out of bounds by Middleton. It will stay with Millwood. The bib will come in for Phillip. He'll sit down. Kushimi inside. Forrest drives baseline. Left it short. Habib spins on Darling. And he'll be forced into the walk. Turnover number 5 committed by the Vikings. Jaden backdoor. Cauley with the follow. Second chance, and he'll lay it up and in. And Fabian Cauley's up to 8. Stolen by Forrest. Tushimi. Forrest for 3. Got it. Lead up to 18 for the Knights. Fowler back and down to Shimmy. Can't get the touch around the rim. Here comes Jaden Lucas, spins in the lane. Blocked by Middleton. Delonte on the run out. And he'll lay it up and in. Gorgeous move by Delonte Middleton. Defensively down the other end, was able to get that help side block. And straight line drive with no resistance to the bucket. Here's Lucas. Gets inside and he's fouled. And that'll be on Fowler. He'll check out of the game. Chris Coggins will come in. So 51.9 remaining in the first half. Millwood leading 43-27. Here's Forrest, steps inside a 3-point line. Bottled up, Coggins corrals the loose ball. Now here's Villa. Villa attacking off the bounce. Euro step, not there. Loose ball picked up by Abib. He'll force it up. And it will stay with the Vikings. Last touch by Millwood. So 14 on the shot clock, 29.6 remaining in the half. Ruben Villa will inbound on the baseline for Yarmouth. Belanger, turnaround, left it short. Ripped down by Downey, turned over. Count it for Middleton, the circus shot plus 1. And he'll go to the line for the chance of the 3-point play. So Damarian Downey throws it away. And Middleton with an opportunity here for the and one. With 17.2 remaining in the half. And Middleton can't get the fall. Here's Forrest with the rebound. Draws the double. Poked away by Middleton. Another steal. He'll charge his way towards the rim. Look out. As Delonte came down hard, appeared to hit the back of his head on the floor, but he'll get back up to his feet. He'll go to the line and shoot a pair. So Delonte Middleton. A couple outstanding defensive plays will earn him an opportunity to shoot 2. And it's 2 shots plus the ball. So the Vikings will call a timeout with 7.9 remaining in the half. Delonte Middleton still appearing to be shaken up on that play, holding the back of his head. He'll shoot 2. As we'll have a conference here in regards to what type of foul we got here. It appears that they'll get 2 shots plus possession. Usually it's a clear path foul or an unsportsmanlike foul. We'll take another look at it. As we go through a sequence of great plays in this matchup between 1 versus 8. As Nathan Dunn will make his way towards the Millwood High School Knights bench, perhaps have a conversation. Nope. Damon Cole, the head coach for the Knights, is looking for an explanation in regards to the foul. And so it will stand. They will get two shots plus possession here with 7.9, trailing by 14. Delonte Middleton still scratching the back of his head. Let's hope he's okay. Appears to be. He's going to take a couple free throws here. As head coach Dana Cunningham and assistant coach Anton Lord deciding to keep Middleton in there to shoot these free throws. And it seems to be no worse for wear. He knocks down the first. And Delonte will knock down both. He's up to 4 points. He'll stay in the game. It'll be Viking basketball. Side O. Villa will inbound with 7.9. Strong close here for the Vikings here in the second quarter. Villa's got to get it in looking. Middleton finds Belanger. He'll flip it up and in. Excuse me, that's a bib. Lucas, count if it goes, it won't. So at the half, Millwood lead by 10. We're back after this break with the Royal LePage 6-8 Realty Group halftime report. This presentation of the 2024 School Sport Nova Scotia Division I Boys Basketball Championships brought to you by Maritime Athletic Profiles will continue after these messages. back in Wolfville, Nova Scotia after 20 minutes. The Knights lead by 10. Let's take a quick look at the numbers in the first half. Millwood with a total of 43 points. And leading the way for the Knights is Fabian Colley with 8. Tyler Mova with 8 as well. Jaden Lucas has 7. And a foul. Donovan Reed's got 4 and 2 fouls. Shane Lucas off the bench has 5. Paul Otho's got 4 for a total of 43 points. And for Yarmouth Consolidated Memorial High School Vikings, leading the way is Tariq Fowler. He leads all scorers with 14 in the game. Delonte Middleton finished strong with 7. And Habib's got 4. So a 10-point game. Number 1 versus number 8. A David versus kind of Goliath affair. As mentioned, the second meeting between these two teams in tournament play. Millwood won by 13. But the Vikings, a wild card berth from the Western region, looking to upset the Capital Region champions for the first time, the Millwood High School Knights. So the second half upon us here. We'll get set as the Knights and the Vikings looking to punch their ticket to the semifinals. The original starting lineup for Millwood is Tashimi, Otho, Reed, Colley, and Jaden Lucas. For the other side, for the Vikings, they'll go with Middleton, Habib, Belanger, Middleton, Villa, and this time they'll start Chris Coggins. As Tariq Fowler appear to be favoring that right ankle, will hobble to the Vikings bench. And that's not good if you're Yarmouth right now. You know, throw it away. Middleton tried to find Belanger on the post up. Fowler will not start the second half. 14 points in the first half for Fowler. And he's on the Viking bench with his leg up. That's not a good sign if you're the Vikings looking for an upset. Here's Lucas, splits the D, lays it up, leaves it short. Habib on the run out to Middleton. Middleton will lay it up, can't finish. Point blank range, Delonte Middleton. Unable to finish with the right hand. Colley poked away by Belanger. And then Coggins throws it away as Otho with the steal. And Paul will go to the line to shoot a pair. So Vikings doing it right now, trying to stay close to see if Tariq Fowler can continue in this contest. At this moment, it does not appear to be that way. Otho way off on the first free throw. He'll miss the second. Last touch by Lucas. Ball over to the Vikings. Here's Villa. Shot clock winding down, under 10. Nice catch in traffic as Belanger blocked by Reed. Stays with it, and Reed will rip down the rebound. Second chance there for Belanger, comes up short. Here's Fashimi, loses the handle. Back door finds Lucas, can't finish at the rim. Fadeaway not there for Jaden. Good chance on that backdoor by Lucas. Couple cracks at it, but unable to finish at the rim. Here's Middleton. Shot clock winding down under 10. Habib's got to get busy. Coggins drives, forces it up, misses everything, and that'll be a shot clock violation. So turnover number 6 on the game for the Vikings. Corner 3 for Altho, got it. Nice soft touch in the corner there for Paul, knocks down the triple. He's got 7. Villa's cut off on the drive, hands it off to Coggins. Now Middleton will look to go inside, uses the screen. Villa for 3, that scrapes the rim. 1 and done for the Vikings, back the other way come the Knights. Lucas thought about 3. Trashimi will try. That'll rim out. Villa, nice pass. Count it, plus the foul, and a chance for the 3-point play. As Delonte Middleton will go to the line to shoot the free throw, and that's Donovan Reed's 3rd personal. And decision time here for Damon Cole. As Reed will get the and one, he's got 10. So Middleton's and one cuts the lead back to 10. Here's Trashimi, splits the D, drops it off to Cauley. That won't go. And a good look in tight there was Cauley. Belanger's 3-pointer. Excuse me, Habib, and he'll chase after it. Knocked out of bounds. It will stay with Yarmouth. As Shane Lucas will come in, Donovan Reed will check out with 3 personals. Frustrating afternoon for the 6'6" senior Reed. Villa were inbound on the baseline. Here's Habib, step back for 3. Won't go, gets his own rebound. Barrels his way in, can't finish. And Cauley with the rebound. Now the Knights on the move. Lucas inside, he'll lay it up and in. Shane Lucas finds his brother once again, Jaden. And Jaden will pick up point number 9 on the game. And another assist for Shane. As Belanger will put it up and in. Nice catch in traffic there for Belanger. Cauley bumped inside, and Cauley will miss the shot. It will stay with Millwood. And Trashimi will inbound. Here's Bury. Lucas looking to go inside. Lucas drives baseline, trips and stumbles and steps out of bounds. Looking for the foul call, not there. Still stuck at 10. Vikings staying in it. Lucas pokes it away. Chased down by Middleton, and Lucas lays it up and in. Outstanding play there on the run out by Jaden Lucas. Was able to rip it away from Middleton. And Jaden's up to double digits. He's got 11 on the game. And an offensive foul on Belanger, trying to get position inside on Fabian Cauley. And Zach Belanger, that's his 2nd. He'll stay in the game, is Belanger. Mulva's in the game for the Knights here in the 2nd half. Otho for 3. Can't hit. Villa bumped by Trashimi. And That was Bury's first. Middleton. Coggins for three. Throws up the air ball. Here's for Shimmy. Lucas on the drive. Lays it up and in. Outstanding explosive move by Shane Lucas. Gets all the way to the rim and lays it up and in. And that'll be Shane's sixth point of the game. Belanger can't handle that pocket pass. Jack Wiseman will check in. Delonte Middleton will check out. Dangerous cross-court pass corralled by Otho. Quick ball movement. Mova for three, won't go. Cauley with the offensive rebound. He'll charge right to the front of the rim. Kick out Otho for three, got it. Second chance opportunity for Millwood, not starting to pile up here. As Paul Otho knocks down his second triple. He's up to 10 now. Belanger fouled by Cauley, he'll shoot two. Cauley will pick up his first, team's third. So Tariq Fowler will give it a go. 14 points in the first 20 minutes for Tariq. Ended that first half with a right ankle sprain. He's trying to stretch it out now. Not sure what you can do much for a ligament. Nonetheless, he's going to try. Is Tariq. Zone here by the Vikings. Otho. To Shemi for three. Won't go. Now Tariq will struggle to get it over the timeline. Explosiveness just not there as he had in the first half. And another turnover committed by the Vikings. As Ryan Miller will check in for the Knights here in the second half for the first time. Here's Lucas. Otho. Under 10. Miller, three-pointer in the corner. Won't go. As Miller knocked to the floor, and he'll get back up. That'll be a foul on Coggins. Lucas gets it back, under 10. Miller, cross court to Lucas. Gotta hurry, Otho for three. This time it won't go. Miller fighting for the rebound, tied up by Wiseman. And possession will favor the Vikings. Here's Fowler, seems to be moving a little bit more secure here. Loses the handle. And Tariq slow to get back up to his feet, helped up by Ryan Miller. He'll make his way back down the other end on defense. You can just see in a lot of pain right now is the senior Tariq Fowler. And he'll stay out there. Otho drives baseline. Cut off by Belanger. Miller in tight. Kick out. Lucas for three. Belanger rips down the rebound, tied up by Miller. And possession will stay with Millwood. Phillip now will check into the game. Belanger will check out. And Victorian Oliver will come in for Millwood. Here's Oliver. Quick ball movement. Mova back, sinks it home. Gotta be kidding me. Knocks down the three-pointer off the glass. And that's his third three-pointer of the game. He's up to 11. Habib leaves it short. Oliver on the run out. Mova lays it up and in. He's got 13 now. Tyler Mova, 6'2" junior off the bench, 13 points. Lucas steals it. Here's Shane on the run out, and he'll lay it up and in. And a timeout called by the Vikings. As assistant coach Anton Lord has seen enough, they'll try to right the ship here. As the reserves for the Knights turning it up for Damon Cole. 22-point lead now. 8-0 run for Millwood. Lucas and Mova off the bench have been outstanding. Tyler's got 13. Lucas has 8 and 4 dimes. So just another reminder. After the opening ceremonies, it'll be game number 3 here on day 1 of these championships, where Armbray Academy will take on Cobequid Education Center. That's a 3-versus-6 matchup here on Maritime Athletic Profiles. Citadel Phoenix knocking off the host, Horton Griffins, in the opener. It will be Viking basketball out of the timeout. Phillip, Coggins, Fowler, Habib, and Wiseman. For the Knights, it's Oliver, Colley, Mova, Miller, and Shane Lucas. Only starter on the floor is Colley for the Knights. And two starters on the floor for the Vikings in Fowler and Habib. Habib inside, posting up Mova. Turns. Fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two. So that'll be Tyler Mova's second personal. Team's fourth. Habib would knock down the first. Gabe had 4 in the first half. He's got 6 now. Miller all alone. Vikings get back on D. Here's Oliver. He'll pull it out. Miller gets it back. Dumps it inside the Colley. Colley turns it over. Here's Fowler. Fowler now seems to be moving a little bit more freely now. Gets to the rim, lays it up, he'll leave it short. Just doesn't have that explosiveness as he had in the first half. Miller inside the Colley. He'll kick it right back up. Shot clock under 5. Mova turns it over. Empty trip for the Knights. 20-point lead, under a minute left in the third period. Stolen by Colley. Here's Oliver on the run out, tried to save it. Unable to do so, and possession will go back to the Vikings. So 15.4 remaining here in the third. A 20-point lead for Millwood. Their largest, 22. Villa now will walk it up over the timeline. Rubens turns the corner and he's thrown to the floor by Colley. And an offensive foul called on Rubens Villa. So he thought he might have had the foul on Colley, but the foul's on him offensively. They're a hole for the last shot are the Knights. And Lucas's three doesn't go. So after three quarters completed, Millwood lead by 20. We're back after these messages with Maritime Athletic Profiles coverage of the 2024 School Sport Nova Scotia Division I Boys Basketball Championships.
QMJHL Friday Night Hockey on Eastlink is presented by CarStar.
Eastlink is the home of QMJHL Friday Night Hockey.
Catapult in! Patrick Catapult!
QMJHL Friday Night Hockey. Friday, March 8th. Hackney Bathurst versus Halifax at 7 p.m. Available only to Eastlink video customers.
Back in Wolfville, Nova Scotia, inside Horton High School Gymnasium. Game number two, the Millwood Knights, the number one seeded team in this tournament, leading the eight seeded Yarmouth Vikings after three periods in the books, leading by 20. As it the reserves for the Knights breaking this one out in the third period. Led by Tyler Mova, 13 points off the bench. Shane Lucas has eight and a couple nice dimes in this game. And Jaden Lucas, who started the game. Shane Lucas's brother, he's got 11. And on the other side, Tariq Fowler still stuck on 14. And there's that foul, an offensive foul on Reuven Villa. And it got called at the end of that third period. Delonte Middleton's got 10. The Bibbs got 6. Villa's got 3. And Belanger's got 2 to round out the scoring for Yarmouth Consolidated Memorial High School. So to start of the fourth period, Millwood up big, 20-point bulge. It'll be Viking basketball. Tariq Fowler will inbound. He'll continue to give it a go here. Villa Middleton, Belanger and Habib. For the Knights, it's Tashimi Reed, who's playing with three fouls. Shane Lucas will get the start. Colley and Otho. Three-pointer not there for Habib. Colley on the runout. Colley loses the handle. Middleton tried to save it on the end line, and it's last touched as Middleton was able to throw it off the foot of Fabian Colley. Phillip picks up his dribble. Delonte Middleton. He'll pull it out. Habib, shot clock winding down. Gotta get busy. Stolen by Colley. Otho attacking, and he'll run right into the chest of Villa, and that'll be an offensive foul. So that'll be his second personal, team's first. As Fowler will readjust his footwear. Villa will inbound. Middleton off the screen. He'll throw it away. Out though, back the other way now for Millwood. Reed, nice catch inside. Here's for Simi, pull up. That'll rim out. Stretch pass, nice catch. It's a bib, push from behind and he'll bank it in. So Gabe Habib fighting through a couple fouls in that sequence. Was able to put away his eighth point on the game. Chishimi. Reed inside, nice catch, and he'll bank it home. Bill off the bounce, drops it off inside to Greek. Fowler will turn it over. Cauley on the run out, and he'll bank it home. And Cauley's up to double digits, he's got 10. Belanger's jumper, not there. Chased down by Habib. Second chance coming up, Villa for three. Won't go, and he'll throw with the rebound. Here's Lucas, and he'll lay it up and in as Middleton try to chase him down from behind. And Shane Lucas has double digits, he has 10. Nice take off the bounce by Villa. He'll convert. Otho in the corner, and that's last touch by Fowler. It will stay with Millwood. Forrest will come back along with Downey for Millwood. Cauley and Trishimi will sit down. Here's Forrest. Otho off the inbound. Yes! And Paul Otho knocks down his fourth three-pointer of the game. Habib spins in the lane, loses the handle. Forrest on the run out. Tacking downhill, blocked by Middleton. And a tie up. As Wiseman and Coggins will come in for the Vikings. Possession arrow will favor Yarmouth. Reese Oliver will check in for the first time for Millwood. The 6'3", grade 9. And Tariq Fowler behind the play. A courageous effort here in this second half for Tariq Fowler. As he'll make his way towards the Yarmouth bench, favoring his left ankle. So 6:28 remaining in regulation. That might be the last time we see Tariq Fowler tonight, but what a courageous effort from that young man. 14 points in the first half, struggled throughout the second half with an apparent ankle injury to his left ankle. Try to give it a go here in the second half. Just didn't have the same explosiveness and determination that he had in the first half, where he was a handful for Millwood, trying to contain him off the bounce. Here's Downey. Gets to the rim. Can't finish. Oliver now on the attack, slips, gets it over to Downey though, three-pointer on the way. Battered around and secured by Otho, another second chance coming up for Millwood. Here's Forrest. Middleton, step for step. Shot clock winding down. Downey for three. Throws up the air ball, and Forrest can't save it on the end line. Middleton brings it over to the timeline. Delonte. Right hand, not there. Last touch by Yarmouth. Possession will go over the Millwood. Lucas will bring it over the timeline. Downey drives baseline, drops it off to Otho. Corner three, yes! Puts it in, Paul Otho, fadeaway three-pointer. 17 for Paul. And he is 4 for 6 from downtown. Belanger tied up by Downey. And possession arrow will favor Millwood. So 5:02 remaining in regulation. Outthrow's day is over. Shane Lucas will go to the bench as well. In there now is Alvin Wiskar. Middleton, scoop shot not there. Boris gets it over the timeline. Here's Oliver. Danico Upshaw in there now. No look pass behind the back for Forrest. Tried to find Downey down low. His last touch, no, it'll be a turnover. Now Middleton will walk it up over the timeline. Villa gets inside. Banked in by Phillip. And a travel on Oliver. Chakala in there now for the Vikings, wearing number 30. Villa, he gets knocked to the floor, doesn't draw the whistle. Phillip didn't hit the rim, bodies flying all over the floor. That'll be a shot clock violation. So Upshaw will walk it over the timeline. Three-pointer not there for Alvin. Gets it back, throws up the wild shot. Downey with the rebound, and that's deflected out of bounds off of Downey's leg. And the carousel of substitutions continuing. In there now is number 3, Lane Cunningham. The freshman. Upshaw called for the foul. Substitution, Forrest will check out. And Luca Smith will come in. Smith wearing number 16 for the Knights. along with number 14, Jake Darlin. Fade away, not there. Phillip finds the loose ball and he'll travel. Morningstar will check in for the first time for the Vikings as Phillip will sit down. So all reserves out there now for both teams. Millwood leading 74-48. Just over 3 minutes remaining in regulation. Downey will pull it out. Upshaw's got to get busy. Here's DeNico. Drops it inside. Darling, desperation shot at the buzzer and doesn't draw iron, and that'll be a shot clock violation. Morningstar brings it over the timeline. Here's Cunningham. Chakao gets it knocked away, picks it back up. Upshaw with the on-the-ball defense. Shot clock winding down. Cunningham spins. That's off the side of the backboard, but he's fouled. And he'll go to the line to shoot two. So Downey will pick up the personal. Lane Cunningham will shoot two. First one rims out. Second one not there for Cunningham. Upshaw will get them organized. Darling from way out throws up the air ball. Rush shot there by Jake Darling. Didn't set his feet. Wasn't really square to the bucket. And possession will go over to the Vikings. Here's Chakal. Chakal's cut off by Smith. Now Morningstar moves it over to Cunningham. Wiseman for three. And that won't fall. Rhys Oliver will check back into the game. As Smith will check out. Upshaw gets it over the timeline. Back door, Darling lays it up and in. Outstanding half-court offense there by the Knights. Executed to perfection. On the back door is Jake Darling able to lay it up and in off the pin-down screen. King will bring it over the timeline. Upshaw with the steal. Oliver on the run out, and he'll lay it up and in. Rhys will get on the stat sheet with a layup. Morningstar. Cunningham, blow by on Darling on the baseline, left it short on the floater. Upshaw with the rebound, Rhys again on the run out. And once again, he'll lay it up and in. 4 points for Rhys Oliver off the bench. That won't go for King. Under a minute remaining in the game. Won't fall. King with the rebound, Cunningham. Oh, tricky dribble there by Lane Cunningham. He's knocked to the floor. Millwood over the limit it appears. Cunningham should be shooting two free throws. No, they'll sustain and say it's only four. Shot clock and game clock bang on. Vikings continuing to attack here. Here's Morningstar. Three-pointer won't fall for Phillips. And Upshaw will bring it over the timeline, and the Knights will dribble this one out. So the Millwood Knights, the number one seeded team here in the tournament, will move on. They win it 80-48. And they will take on the Citadel Phoenix tomorrow at 2 p.m. here on Maritime Athletic Profile. So the Phoenix and the Knights in the first semifinal tomorrow afternoon. And we will wait to see who else will punch their ticket to that 4 p.m. semifinal. Well, the final, once again, Millwood 80, Yarmouth 48. So for my producer, once again, Dylan Jones and Maritime Athletic Profiles, I'm Vince Williams saying thank you for watching the 2024 School Sport Nova Scotia Division I Basketball Championships. We'll be back, but so long for now from Whitfield, Nova Scotia.
So we have two awards. more days. This is just the beginning.
Some of these things when we said in our athletes play your dedication, your hard work. We expect that you're going to play hard and play fair. You are a student athlete, and you're here to represent your school and your community. So please continue to make sure that they are proud of you. And we'd like to wish you all the best of luck in your courses and your other endeavors this year. My following word will be for the graduates. Now I was going to ask the graduates to step forward. They're probably not going to work. Just raise your hand. Graduates?
Oh. CPA.
Thank you. I just want to take this time to acknowledge and thank Corey Palmer for our manager for all of his work over the last couple of years. Corey, I'm going to be on the stairs. Corey's an absolute rock star in the hall.